Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. There are many things that are far more important than the meager fare that is on offer this week in terms of tech news, but I'm not going to talk about any of them because as we teeter precariously between summer and fall, poised like a roller coaster at the apex of a mountainous drop towards the holiday season, sometimes what we really need is a week of less important tech news with mildly interesting morsels such as AMD picking Transformers codenames for their RDNA5 GPUs, Nvidia slowing down 8GB video card production, or a robot laser weed machine. If all that leaves you feeling short of breath, you should seek medical help. But if not, it's time for tech news.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Corsair Xenion Edge 14.5-inch LCD touchscreen, a 2560 by 720 resolution 60Hz panel designed to attach to your monitor, mount to your PC case, or to be front and center in your setup with the detachable magnetic stand. Connection is easy via HDMI or USB-C with DisplayPort Alt mode support, and the 5-point touchscreen allows you to easily control what's displayed, whether that's system stats via Corsair's IQ software integration, app widgets, a live chat feed while streaming, or just some background music or video playback. Vertical and horizontal orientation are both supported, so for more on the Xenion Edge touchscreen, click the sponsor link in the video description. As I vaguely alluded to in the intro, this week we're doing the show Tech Brief style, so buckle up. Starting with some Nvidia rumors, which are sourced from the board channel's forums. But if true, we should all give ourselves a pat on the back, likely thanks to the enthusiast community's lack of enthusiasm for 8GB graphics cards in 2025. It is said that Nvidia will be reducing the supply of RTX 5060 Ti 8GB by 15% and the RTX 5060 8GB by 30%. Apparently, word spread regarding 8GB inadequacy and demand was weaker than expected in the first half of this year. Rumors have also been swirling about Nvidia launching RTX 50 Super GPUs with boosted VRAM capacity later this year, although many have been waiting for more widespread leaks than the couple of sources on that news so far. If the Supers are arriving, though, then this news of RTX 5080 and 5070 Ti production halting in October wouldn't be surprising either. Nvidia will likely replace a few non-super cards in the stack to keep things from getting too crowded. The Steam hardware survey for August also went live Monday, and some interesting trends were discovered. The shift from 16 to 32 gigabytes of system memory as the most popular setup is well underway and could tip before year's end. And while the RTX 4060 retook the top spot as the number one GPU this month, the RTX 50 series is climbing the charts as well, with the RTX 5070 in the lead amongst the current gen. Not a single Radeon RX 9000 series card from AMD is individually listed here, though. And if you want further proof of Nvidia's continued dominance in the discrete GPU market space, there was also a Q2 JPR report posted Tuesday that says Team Green has 94% market share, an increase of 2.1%, and GPU shipments in general were up 27%. I've recently been applying my cold analytical skills to PC hardware codenames and how cool or not cool they sound, so imagine my delight when these pseudonyms for Radeon RDNA5 GPUs popped up this week. Again, we're very much in rumor territory, but according to Kepler_L2, AMD went with Transformers-inspired codenames, which feels like cheating, but is pretty cool nonetheless. Alpha Trion is said to be the codename for the whole discrete GPU lineup, Ultra Magnus is for the Xbox SoC, and Orion Pax, aka Optimus Prime, is for the PlayStation 6 SoC. Hopefully, RDNA5 will be more than meets the eye, but I can't be the only one who wished they would have used Starscream for something.
Our clever leader doesn't know what it does!
Now, Intel may suck at codenames by comparison due to their ongoing lake fetish, but Team Blue is clearly beating AMD in one area: leaks about next-gen CPUs. Last week, we saw 28-core Nova Lake S CPUs, and this week, Intel has already nearly doubled the core count to 52, per more shipping manifests that aren't for engineering sample CPUs, but rather test equipment like aluminum jigs. Core counts are clearly listed, though, as is the socket, LGA 1954, which is the same size as LGA 1851, so cooling solutions should cross over, though they won't be backwards compatible with current-gen CPUs and motherboards. A 52-core Nova Lake S desktop CPU will likely use two standard Nova Lake S desktop compute tiles on the same package, resulting in twice the performance cores, 16 instead of 8, as well as 32 efficient cores and 4 low power cores for when the efficient cores aren't efficient enough. Big questions remain as to when the new platform and CPUs will launch, as there's still an Arrow Lake refresh for LGA 1851 apparently coming later this year, but Nova Lake S seems to be getting fast-tracked, so it might debut earlier in 2026 rather than later. Next, in what is, I guess, a win for PC-building Americans, the 25% tariff on GPUs and other PC hardware made in China has had its exemption extended by 3 months, which has been happening quarterly since 2019. It would have kicked back in September, but has now been extended until November 29th. This applies to motherboards and SSDs as well, so not having all those components suddenly jump in price by 25% or so just before the holidays is a good thing. In the same way that not hitting yourself in the head with a hammer is also a good thing. You'd think maybe we could just put the hammer down and stop threatening to do that, but nope, in 3 more months, the hammer will drop again, unless they extend the exemption again. CPUs with integrated graphics are becoming more and more powerful, and late last week there was a leaked benchmark for Nvidia's N1X, which is the most likely competitor for the likes of AMD's Strix Halo solutions, and aside from the impressive Geekbench score pulled from the database, the N1X specs are looking quite impressive. It has 20 CPU cores, with half being ARM Cortex-X925 and the other half being A725, but the GPU specs rival the RTX 5070 with 48 SMs and 6,144 CUDA cores, though power limits will likely apply as these chips are most likely to appear in handhelds and mobile devices. The test system apparently also had 128 gigabytes of shared system memory though, which hints at higher-end workstation configurations that might be based off the N1X. There's a whole new breed of PCs with high-end GPU performance in the works, and I'm very curious to see how these match up against full-size desktops when they're made available for consumers to purchase. Finally, let's talk about weed. No, not the good kind. Weeds and lasers and AI and GPUs. Mash these all together and you get the appropriately named LaserWeeder G2, made by Carbon Robotics, which is an up to 20-foot-wide tractor-pulled agricultural robot. The largest model uses 24 Nvidia GPUs and the same number of high-powered lasers to scan the field beneath the unit and zap 10,000 weeds a minute into oblivion, while also gathering images to feed its large plant model AI service, which promises to further refine the detection of undesirable weeds versus crops, which is particularly helpful as many weeds have developed resistance to pesticides. But there's no such thing as a laser-resistant weed, per Carbon Robotics CTO. It's a fascinating real-world use for AI tech that I want for my backyard, or I did before I realized they're upwards of $1 million each, so I'll stick to weeding manually for now. But there you have it, guys, tech news for the week, and if you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all of the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested in reading more, and you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high-quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my channel is always a good call too. Thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you next week.